Sorry for being a mess.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are doing well. Now, I have been giving you a lot of product recommendations of lately, products you need to try, need to buy, and I think it's equally important to give you guys recommendations on products you need to run away from. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about products I regret buying, products that sadly didn't work for me. But before starting, I have to say that products are so subjective. Some things that might work for me might not work for you, and vice versa. So please, I always encourage you guys to see multiple reviews before investing your hard-earned money into a product. Also, I have to quickly say that if my recommendations have ever worked for you and you like my recommendations, then you should probably just run away from these products ASAP, because you know they didn't really work for me. Just saying that. And again, the last point that I have to say before beginning this video is I'm not trying to bash any company that I mentioned in this video. I probably love and use so many other products by the companies. It's just that every company has their own misses here and there. It's impossible to have 100% you know success rate in any field. So without any further ado, if you want to see some products I regret buying and why I regret buying them, then please keep on watching. Let's start off with hair care, because I only have one product as of right now, and if you've been following my videos off lately, you would know what product this is gonna be. It's the Mamaearth Tea Tree Shampoo. Now, there are a couple of issues with this product. Let's go over them one by one. First of all, the product in itself is too thick. It's so thick that the pump doesn't work properly because the product doesn't come out of the pump easily. So you have to really jag it up, or you have to like open up the packaging and then use the product. But that's a very topical, a very superficial issue with this product. This product doesn't do what it says. It says it's for dandruff-free hair. Now, I have very dry scalp and it does tend to get flaky if the weather is changing, or if it's too cold, or if I bathe with hot water, but this does not help with the flakes at all. It actually made my scalp even drier, which was just like, why would you do that? Also, you need a lot of this shampoo to clean your hair. Like, it's insane the amount that you need. I literally finished up a bottle so quickly because I was using so much shampoo to clean my hair. My hair was dirty and greasy even after washing with this. So that's why I regret buying this. And if you have hair that's even slightly oily, stay away from this. Moving on to skincare, the first product we're going to be talking about is Dot & Key 5% AHA Toner. First of all, I love the packaging and I love the fact that AHAs and BHAs are finally making their way into the Indian market, but this product sadly is something you should be staying away from. Now, I personally don't mind fragrances in my products because it doesn't irritate my skin, but if you have sensitive skin type, obviously perfumes do matter to you, and this one has a high amount of perfume in there. It's supremely high. You could literally use this as a perfume on your underarms, and I think that's what I'm going to be doing, so that my underarms are also exfoliated, because the amount of perfume that's in there, it's a spray bottle. First of all, it's a spray bottle, and spraying an AHA toner on your face isn't the most sensible thing to do, because it can go near your eyes and all of that, and you don't want that to happen. Now, I get it, you can just use it on your cotton pad, spray it on your cotton pad and then use it, or spray it on your hands and tap it into your skin. Again, that is not the basic issue that I have. The basic issue that I have is that the perfume in here, because it's so high, it literally, you inhale it. I couldn't breathe after using this. I tried to use this about 6 to 7 times, and every time I applied it, I had to stop breathing. And even if I breathed after like a gap of 30-40 seconds, the moment I inhaled, is the perfume was something I was inhaling, and it made me feel so uncomfortable and just so, I don't even know what to say. So the perfume in this needs to be dialed down to almost nil if possible, because it's so difficult to use this. And this is coming from someone who uses perfumes in her products. Almost all of my products have perfume and fragrances, and it doesn't irritate me, but this one, it's just too high. So I would literally be using this as a perfume on my underarms. Okay, next up we have Roots & Herbs Moisturizer. Now, this is not a moisturizer, it's actually an oil, and it's not a good one. Now, this one, it's too heavy for the skin. I don't know what's in there, because they only mention the key ingredients, and obviously key ingredients are always the good ingredients, but it's so heavy on the skin. It feels very cloggy on the skin. The perfume again is nauseating. It's literally to an extent that it's nauseating. You don't feel like putting on your skin. I use this one as a cuticle oil because I don't want to put it on my face, as I feel like whenever I put it on my face, it makes my pores so clogged, and so my skin feels heavy and dragged and just not the best. And again, I'm from dry skin family. Oils are supposed to be my best friend. If something feels heavy on my skin, then if you have oily skin or even normal skin, I can't even imagine what your skin must feel after using this. Moving on to our next product, I have the Farsali Volcanic Elixir with me. This is a Polynesian beauty oil. First of all, I don't know what's in there that smells so bad, but let's keep that fact aside. This one stung my eyes so bad. I'm not even kidding you. My eyes could give a run to Narmada because everyone would be wanting to build a dam right here. The amount of water that my eyes secreted after using this was insane, and it happened night over night over night. I thought one day maybe, you know, my eyes are tired and that's why they're watering. So I tried it again, same thing, again, same thing, again, same thing. So if you have sensitive eyes or even near about sensitive eyes, stay away from this because it will make your eyes water. There is something in there that just makes your eyes water. I don't know what, because the only ingredient that's mentioned on the box as well as on the site is tamaru oil, the Polynesian beauty oil. It's just a one ingredient thing in here. So I don't know what's in there that makes my eyes sting so bad. Another thing was that they claim that's a miraculous oil that you're supposed to wake up with beautiful looking skin in a day or two. I know that skincare is a long drawn process and I don't expect miraculous results, but when companies claim that it gives miraculous results, we've got to talk about it. It doesn't give any miraculous results. It works just like a normal oil. You know, you could be using any other facial oil that you love and prefer, and it would perform as same, like similar to this. I actually have oils that perform better than this. Again, I have nothing against Farsali, but I feel like so many of their products are just overhyped rather than actually be having some substance to them. So this one goes into my list of regrets. The last skincare item we have is the Innisfree Canola Honey Lip Balm. Now I've completely finished it up. It's going to be in my next empty soon because I just wanted to get rid of this. I'm not even kidding you. I love lip balms, but this one was so bad. It's not moisturizing at all. It just creates like a waxy layer on your lips. That's not even like, it doesn't even feel protective. Vaseline does a better job than this at least making you feel like you're doing something for your lips. So this one is a bad lip balm. I had to reapply it, I think about 8 or 9 times during the day just to make sure that my lips felt a little bit of moisturization. And my mom felt the same way about this. So this one is a no-no from my side. Moving on to makeup, the first product actually breaks my heart into pieces. It's the Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Filter. Now, I'm not saying this is a bad product. It's a beautiful product, makes your skin look good, glowy, nice and dewy. And that's my issue with this product, that there are so many products out there that actually perform in a similar way and cost like 1/10 of what this costs. And that's why this makes it to my regret list, because I've spent so much money on it. I felt like I would be getting something, you know, wow. But this one is just a very normal average light medium highlighter that you can just apply on your skin and your skin would look beautiful. YBP Goddess would do a similar thing, NYX Strobe Cream would do a similar thing, MAC Strobe Cream would do a similar thing, even Maybelline has a strobing cream that would do a similar thing, and that's why I regret buying this. Moving on, I have the Makeup Revolution Banana Powder with me, the luxury banana powder with me. Now this one is a direct copy of the Ben Nye Banana Powder that was a rage. I think about 8 years ago when I first joined the YouTube community, banana powder was the thing. You needed to have banana powder. Ben Nye wasn't sadly available at that point in India, and not a lot of companies were shipping to India, so I never got my hands on it, and the rage died down, and then I realized that my skin is so dry that powder, anyway, I don't need a lot of powder. Now I bought this because everyone in the beauty community was raving about it. They're like, it's amazing, it's great, it looks beautiful on the under eyes. And I was so disappointed. I was disappointed, and how? First of all, it's not super finely milled, so there are some discrepancies in the product and you can literally feel the different particle sizes on your under eyes. Secondly, it doesn't sit well on the under eyes. It makes them look so patchy and so dry and just so crusty. I did not like how it sat on my under eyes. It just wasn't nice. It clung on to my fine lines. It wasn't good. And I don't even bake with this. I don't even bake in general. Just the setting part of it, it was just like, no, not happening. I would suggest you to go for a Maybelline Fit Me or a K-Beauty loose powder over it if you want to get that smooth under eye effect, because this one is a nada. The next product I'm going to be talking about is something that I've used, I've loved, I've recommended as well, but now I have some serious doubts about it and I regret using it ever. I'm talking about the Australis Makeup Finishing Spritz. Now I've really liked this product since a while, but there are 2 months to go for the expiry of this product, and since the last 6 months something has been growing inside it. These definitely weren't there earlier. I saw photographs and other videos of people as well, just to make sure that I didn't miss out on some extract being in there. I don't know what's been growing in there, I don't know what I've been putting on my face, but this is gonna go into the bin. I regret buying this because I don't know the formulation, if it's not stable or what's the problem or what's growing inside it. It really freaks me out. Alrighty, moving on to the last product of this list. This is something I have a full review on, and I would highly recommend you guys to watch it so that you know my full lowdown on this product. But we're going to be talking about Maybelline Superstay Ink Crayons today. Now, if you don't want to watch the whole video, let me quickly give you a glimpse and recap of what these crayons are. Boring colors, overpriced, not Superstay at all. They wear out between 4 to 5 hours. And that's why I think, you know, these are not something you need to buy. And yes, with that we finished this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you did, then don't forget to comment and subscribe. It would mean the absolute world to me. Also, let me know what other videos you guys would like to see, and I would love to do them for you guys. I'll see you guys next time. Till then, take care. I love you all so much. Mwah. Bye.